It's not a bird, you know, and you know, in our belief, you know, so it's a connection between us and the spirit world, as we call it, or the afterlife. Well, I don't see a bird, you know, I don't see a bird or an animal. And when I see an eagle, I don't see that, you know. I see, we say Tunkashida, and that means our grandfathers are the ones that came before us. And that's really what I see. You know, I believe in our ways, and I believe, you know, that in within that animal, that spirit of my ancestors is there. The eagle we hold like is the best hunter. It's the swiftest of the birds, you know, and it has the best vision, you know, and so those things, those attributes are very important to us. And, you know, to me as a leader, you know, these are the things that, you know, you look to the animals, you know, not only, we don't only hold the eagle in reference and reverence, but, you know, we look at all animals and we try to take those things from them. And so as a leader, you know, you take those things, you know, that long-sighted vision that the eagle has. As a leader, it's important that you have that vision. If you were given an eagle feather, it was for a great accomplishment or whatever it is. So we've taken that and adapted it into the modern day lifestyle. When our children graduate from high school, they're adorned with the eagle feather, or the girls are adorned with eagle plumes. You know, maybe if they went into the service and they've come back, the other veterans will honor them by giving them gifts of eagle feathers. We still honor our leaders in that way too. So, you know, that symbolism has continued, but it has adapted somewhat over time.